Hello everyone. So in this video again we have a very interesting question for you pertaining to positive integers and progressions. So let's take a look. For n greater than 1, call an infinite series a1, a2, dot 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 an of positive integer progressive if ai is less than ai plus 1 and ai divides ai plus 1. For all I less than equal to 1 and less than equal to n minus 1. Or I greater than equal to 1 and less than equal to n minus 1. Find the number of progressive sequences that sum of the term in sequence is 360. Okay, so this is our question. Now, here are a few things that we should actually need to consider. Suppose the first term is x. Okay, now dividing the entire series, the entire series by x will we can actually find the number of progressive sequence whose sum would actually be 360 by x minus 1. Okay, and the first term of which will not be equal to 1. So, first term. Okay, so this is our general observation. Now, if AK denotes number of progressive sequence whose first term not equal to 1 and first term not equal to 1 and sum equal to k, therefore we can express n as, let me write it in a different form. We can actually express a n as something like this, equal to a to the power a 359 plus a 179 plus a 1190 plus a 89 a 71 plus a 59 a 44 plus a 39 plus a 35 plus a 29 plus a 23 plus a, what is it, 20, a of 19 followed by a of 17 plus a of 14, a of 11, plus a of 9, a of 8, a of 7, a of 5, a of 4, a of 3, a of 2, plus a of 1, plus 1. Okay. Here this plus 1, this particular plus 1 at the end, basically it accounts for the sequence whose only term is 360. So only term is 360. So it basically represents that particular sequence. Okay. Fortunately, so now many of these numbers are prime and we only have a of p equal to 1 for primes. So most of, so the only possible thing would be a of p equal to 1 is only possible when p is equal to prime. also A of 1 equal to 0. So therefore, we can further write this particular sequence or the representation of n as nb 15 plus A of 119 plus A of 44 plus A of 39 plus A 35 plus A 14 plus A 9 plus A 8 plus A 4. So we'll take in all the non-primes. Now, having said that, for small k, like 4, 8, 9, it is basically k is less than 21. It is easier to compute. Like we have A of 4 equal to 1, A of 8 equal to 2, and A of 9 equal to 2. But so this can be easily computed. Now, for values like larger k, that is say A of 14, 15, 13, 14, 35, 39, 44, 119, for this we can actually use the recursive of a previously computed value. So let me give you an example of the same. Like A of 14 would be 1 plus A of 6. So that is 1 plus 2 equal to 3. Okay, similarly, A of 35 would be 1 plus A of 6 plus A of 4, in turn 1 plus 2 plus 1, so equal to 4. A of 39 would be 2 plus A of 12, that is 2 plus 4 equal to 6. A of 44 would be 2 plus A of 21 plus A of 10. Basically 2 plus 4 plus 2 equal to 8. And A for 119 would be 1 plus A of 16 plus A of 6, being 1 plus 3 plus 2 equal to 6. Okay, so with that said, now if we want to find out our answer, so the answer would simply be n being 15 plus this value. 15 we got it from here, this value, plus 1, 2. So we'll basically add up all these values, plus 6 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 2 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 into 47, which is our required answer. So hopefully the process involved in the solution is clear to you, as in how we came about with the solution was the same. So kindly go through the video multiple times so that you can have a clear understanding of the same, and you can actually easily compute whatever makes sense or whatever process that we have used towards the solution in general. So what I'd suggest you to do is, with the video as a reference, try and solve the question on your own so that you can get a better insight on the same. So with that said, we have come to the end of the video, so I'm signing out. Thank you so much.